squad, it's your girl KDZ Baby, and I'm back again with another video for y'all. And of course, I'm continuing on after reacting to all of the squad's videos. You know what I'm saying? I am finally resuming the video reactions to the requests that were sent in by the winners of this week. So you know what I'm saying? In this video, I'm gonna be reacting to Camila's Gay Moments 2020. I have a lot of other videos I'm going to be uploading for you guys tonight, tomorrow night, the night after that. So make sure you subscribe. Make sure you hit that bell so you know that I post these videos. I love Camila, you know what I'm saying? I love Fifth Harmony. So I was one of those people that, I was one of those fans that wasn't a big, like, I didn't show favoritism to Camila. You know what I'm saying? I honestly don't think Camila is the best one. You get what I'm, or was the best one. My favorites are probably Dinah and Armani, you know what I'm saying? Yes, sir, but yeah, I feel like Dinah's a powerhouse, first of all. And Armani, talk about, yeah, like she's been the most, I feel like she's improved the most out of the whole group, you know what I'm saying? From beginning all the way up to her solo career. You know, they're all killing it though. So this is her Gay Moments. Camila's Gay Moments of 2020. I can definitely, you know what I'm saying, think about some moments that they could put in here, you know, coming from a harmonizer. So yeah, I'm gonna just start recording this video right now. So recording my screen. We're gonna get into this video. Let's get into it. 1, 2, 3.
How does that feel?
It's actually, this album is not really about boys, though.
Yeah, it's not always just about the boys. Okay, I think her behavior, so her behavior around the girls though is different, I feel like, because, you know, she, I mean, I feel like with anybody, that's why they were able to put this compilation together, one of many, because Camila is very touchy, very affectionate to anybody, you know, so it's just like, I feel like it was really easy to put this up together and make it seem like her Gay Moments, you know? But Camila never did come out as bisexual, did she? Y'all can let me know. Now, her and Dinah, and of course her and Lauren, but Lauren shut that down, period. Boop. But yeah, her and Dinah. Camila's just like, okay, this was not comfortable. We should just, you know. I don't even know if this is just music the whole time.
You are represent Britain as a whole right now. That's why I'm coming out.
Thank
of
you
the
for correcting me.
Incorrect name closet.
Yeah.
And just saying.
She uses gender neutral words to describe what she's talking about. She doesn't specify the.
This song is about when I fell for somebody and I knew that it would be really hard to recover.
Like I heard the Frank played me the track, like the instrumental for Never Be the Same. And I thought of this person that I had a romantic relationship thing, whatever
right.
It was.
Yeah,
I love Into It because it's just, you know, it's basically just
I love all these years.
For such a long time. And I was just daydreaming about this person. And Into It was basically like just the thing that I would say. That person.
So yeah, she's just like that person, you know, not a he, not a she, that person. Every single time they talk about Never Be the Same, which I mean I wouldn't be surprised, but I don't know. Let me know down in the comments what your favorite Camila Cabello song is. Mine is probably Something's Gotta Give. Something's Gotta Give is like I can't even talk. you know, the song is very emotional and I connect to it on a deeper level. That is in my sad music playlist right there. Every time I listen to that song, like, I can close my eyes, I can, you know, I could maybe cry a few times, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's one of those songs. It just makes me really think. You get it? Because if you've been through the lyrics are very meaningful. If you think you've been through that kind of thing, then, you know, it makes an impact. I can't even talk.
No, we'll see. I don't know. I'm not really looking for a boy right now.
Yes. Yes.
To be honest with you,
but
I'm tired of looking for people.
Oh, tired of looking for people.
I just love the rose emoji. I think there's something about it that's so. It just. I always picture me giving a rose to somebody. It's just very poetic, and romantic to me.
Okay. Asia_A says, "Dear Camila, my girlfriend wants our relationship a secret because she's afraid of coming out. Can you give me insights or advice on what to do?" I feel like, I mean, that's such a personal thing, but I feel like everybody, I think that she'll be ready to do that when she's ready to do that, and I don't think
everybody was thinking she was talking about it.
Because you never know what they're going through. You don't know what their relationship is like with her family. You don't know, you know, how comfortable she is with it herself. Maybe it's new to her. I think that it's important to just make sure that just she feels supported and just be like, hey, I love you. And hopefully she has a good support system that make her feel, you know, accepted and loved. But I think that everybody probably comes out at their own time. So all you can do
is
feel
really
supported
true.
And loved. And when she's ready, she will do it. But I've learned that with stuff like that, in the meantime, all you can do is just love them. So yeah, just love
She's
them.
Probably talking about, like, with somebody else, but I can get why they twisted
and
it.
And you were talking about being hurt. I was like, who is, if it's a dude, who is he? I want to get after him. I'm going to call Pitbull, J Balvin.
I think there's also something for
dude.
Me about writing with girls and girl energy. I just feel like we just kind of understand each other more, if that makes sense. Like, I'm less afraid with girls. I love women, and I love girls, and I love the bond,
and it was just feels very powerful, and I was just like, I love girls, like, it's just, you know, girl love.
Yeah, she tried to, like, really, like,
stream live and on demand.
She thought about it, she was like, it might be taken wrong. She tries to, like, clean it up.
Really, there's just nothing like it, you know.
On the speed. No, don't try. It's been a secret for the longest time. Don't run.
Wait.
Oh, yeah.
One? Yes, love. It is I.
This was funny.
I was in the closet.
So now you're out of the closet?
I beg you for more, more. There we go. That's another fire. Oh, no, 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 no. There you go. You're making me a liar. I kind of like it though.
The state in which the sexual orientation or gender identity of an LGBTQ individual is known to many but not publicly acknowledged, essentially. I didn't really have to come out. That's interesting. Then again, I think maybe Camila is also using these words, like, in this way. If she's not really, you know, bisexual, then she's probably saying it because she knows she has a lot of fans that are trans and, you know, go by these terms. And she wanted to make them comfortable. But that might be a stretch, I don't know. But I do know they had a lot of those kind of fans. You know what I'm saying? But I don't know, but even if she was, she's with Sean now, right? Like, they're still kicking it. I don't know.
They just, I'm
happy here. Yeah.
I miss them, bro. I miss them. Dinah follows me on Twitter.
Like, they're so attractive here.
Yeah, I think what generally happens when you're in love with a monster, when you're in love with a quote-unquote bad boy,
I'm in love
or bad,
with a monster.
I get intimidated with this many women in one room. You know.
Me too.
It's good to see.
Okay.
She's not kidding.
There's enough for me to go around.
And being a woman going,
yes,
it's like,
I mean, I can't
so
even
hormones,
imagine.
It's an emotion.
So many hormones.
Look at how Dinah, Normani looking at her.
With other women.
I don't know that.
But
other women.
Yeah, being a woman with other women, it's hard, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. In the beginning.
Who's the guy that makes you guys go crazy?
Why do you assume it's a boy?
Who's the girl that makes you go crazy?
J-Lo.
So, can you imagine, let's say you're in a relationship with a guy.
Ooh,
and,
wow.
And he has this, he's complicated.
It's time to check the sound. In other words, sound check. The sound on the check was sound.
I remember this. This is one of the iconic things.
Put the little peck on check. And you go kiss respect. What's up?
Yeah, I must say that was a little weird. Because Lauren's just like.
Me too.
Christina.
Look at you.
Christina, boy.
Are they in the United States?
No.
They're very passionate here.
Well, like a whole stampede, and they're like just pulling our hair and stuff.
I'm just, it's fun.
Oh, I do know that.
It's
right.
On the go, but at the same
time, one beaver.
They're both super talented.
But not in a creepy way.
But I'm excited about the guest campaign.
Dude, it's huge. You look amazing.
I'm so excited. I mean, it was such a huge honor for me.
Yeah. Anything else you're gonna surprise us with?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So we'll just wait for things. There's things coming on. Okay. Camila, thank you so much.
Thank you.
For giving us.
I literally just winked so weirdly. I was like,
I didn't even see it. Wait. Can you? I can't wink.
Wink.
Oh.
Thank you.
That was great.
Thank you.
Congratulations on everything.
Thank
just
you.
Good luck with everything, and we can't wait for the album. We're all so excited.
You.
Okay. Cool. Oh, no. I see the okay. Yeah, the background is like colorful, like the, you know, the pride flag. But the woman's hand, okay. I do like that. It'll never be the same. Camila got the vocals though. Say what I want to say after. Just might hit it. I never ever. Oh, yeah. Okay. Okay. So what I was gonna say is, so since the fact that when she performed it in that specific performance was very, you know, it's a little sus in a way. You know, I wish she would explain it more, or if she has already. What did she say about that? You know, so, like, never be the same. She always referred to it as being about somebody, someone, a person. And so, in the background, it's, like, the pride colors. Yeah, then she has all these girls, you know, touching on her. The lyrics. Touching me, feeling me. Yeah, so, I don't know. Camila, I mean, it's crazy because you would think that if she really was, though, that she would have said it already, because she knows that it could be a big impact on her fans that haven't came out and all that. But for some reason, I think it's just a coincidence. It may be. I don't know, man. It's tough. It's tough. Tell me what you guys think in the comments. Make sure you guys give this video a like. Comment down below for any other videos you want me to watch. I've already seen a lot of camera videos and all that extra stuff, so you might not want to request those because I already saw them. But make sure you guys hit that subscribe button. Hit that bell so you know when I post videos like this. If you do subscribe, and if you do hit that bell, you will see me in the next video. Stay lit. Yeah. It's K-Dizzy, baby.